Thank you. Mr. Malosh, as student body vice president, it is my honor to present to you the graduating class of 2022.
We will now sing our national anthem.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Now, I'm pleased to introduce our superintendent, Mr. Scott Francis.
Good evening, graduates, friends, families, loved ones, and the Berkley Schools community. I'm excited to be here tonight. As I begin this evening, I'd like to introduce and thank our school board for their hard work throughout the year. Our school board sets the tone for high expectations for the whole school district. And I'd like to introduce each of them and ask them to stand. Please hold your applause until all seven of them have been introduced. Our trustees are Mitchell Moses, Cheryl Stoddard, and Ron Justice. Our officers are Treasurer Mike Tripp, Secretary Sarah Mountain, Vice President Keith Logston, and President Roger Blake. I'd like to also introduce our central office team. This group of people work behind the scenes, and they are intently focused on helping our administrators and staff create the conditions for all students to succeed. Again, please hold your applause until all are introduced. Our team is Deputy Superintendent Larry Gallagher, Assistant Superintendent Chris Sandoval, Director of Student Services Heather Lackey, Director of Teaching, Learning, and Technology Megan Ashkenani, and Director of Communications, Jessica Stilger, who is in the audience taking pictures of this wonderful evening. Thank you. I would like to also acknowledge Principal Andy Malosh, Assistant Principals Evelyn Coleman and Carolyn Krieger, and their team of teachers, counselors, secretaries, and support staff. And I'd also like to make a special mention of Mrs. Olson and Ms. Flood, our senior class advisors. Yeah. They have done an incredible job despite some of the challenges. Please join me in giving them another round of applause. Next, I'd like to share how wonderful it is to be here tonight, and what an honor it is to serve in my first year as your superintendent. I've been in education since 1999, a few years before our graduates were even born. My first year in Berkley Schools was in 2014 as principal at Pattengill Elementary. And interestingly enough, that 2014 fifth grade class is sitting in front of me tonight, ready to graduate. My first year of superintendent allowed me to observe some wonderful events, such as pep rallies, the outdoor ones, the indoor ones, the concerts, the sporting events, plays, clap outs, just to name a few. But I'll also never forget inadvertently experiencing another special event that seniors participate in every year. You see, living in the community where you work has many positives, but it can also present some unexpected encounters from time to time. For example, one evening, I was walking down to a friend of mine who lives down the street, and I was walking up to his house, and I noticed that he had this umbrella wedged between two cars. I thought this was a little out of place, but I didn't give much thought to it as I walked up to his house. And then all of a sudden, a senior, Lillian, jumped out with a very large super soaker in hand. Fortunately, I did not get sprayed that night, but I learned about water wars, which I've been told by Mr. Malosh is not a school-sponsored activity. This year, I've also had some interesting requests from students along the way. For example, I was often asked, I know we're supposed to get an inch of snow tomorrow, but can we have a snow day anyway? The answer to that question was no, but you did get a few snow days this school year. Another time when I was at the high school for a basketball game, a student came up to me and she said, can you help me and my friends get into Mr. Meacham's classroom? They wanted to place this giant picture of his face on a ceiling tile as one of his classroom traditions of designing the ceiling tiles. I may or may not have helped with that one, Mr. Meacham. Just recently, I was also asked if a student can borrow my master key to the high school to help with the senior prank. Now that one got denied. This year provided me with many wonderful memories and requests that I will not forget. And I hope you hold on to those good memories at BHS. Now, onto the class of 2022, a memorable class, a class that hasn't experienced a normal year of high school since freshman year. And let's be honest, is there such a thing as a normal freshman year? I'm speaking as a parent of a freshman daughter at Berkley High School. What I know about this class is that you've all faced unique challenges over the past 4 years, and we are also proud of you for accomplishing your goals. You had to be flexible throughout the pandemic as we changed from in-person to virtual to hybrid and back to in-person. Throughout those years, you were innovative and creative, but most importantly, you remained hopeful that you would get to this point, graduation night, prepared for the next chapter in your life. Allow me to share some additional facts about the graduating class of 2022. While at BHS, an impressive 74% of you have taken at least one advanced placement class. That is a college-level class. Very, very few schools in the nation can match that level of achievement. Also, your graduating class had more students than ever take vocational ed classes and explore trade certifications at the Oakland School's technical campuses. Nearly 25% of you were in the band, orchestra, choir, and/or drama. 32% of you distinguished yourselves on the athletics fields, and an amazing 68% of you are graduating with honors tonight. Those are impressive statistics, and as a class, you should be incredibly proud of yourselves. But let me also share with you that when I graduated from high school, I didn't fall into any of those categories. I didn't graduate with honors. I didn't take a single AP course. I didn't participate in the performing arts, although I wish I would have. I was on an athletic team or two, but I wouldn't say I had a distinguished career. Despite not having those accomplishments in high school, I like to think that I figured out what's important to me to help others succeed. Let me go on to tell you a little bit more about the class of 2022. You and your classmates have earned well over $8.5 million in scholarships. And you have accumulated over 4,050 hours of community service. C Several of your peers will be serving the country as they enter the United States Army, Navy, and Air Force. More students than ever are taking gap years and exploring their options. In an increasingly competitive college application process, 86% of those who applied to Michigan State were accepted. And 44% of those applying to the University of Michigan were accepted. In addition to Michigan and Michigan State, some of you are headed to Eastern, Western, Central, Michigan Tech, Kalamazoo College, Wayne State, and Oakland Community College as well. Others were accepted at and or will be attending Southern University and A&M in Baton Rouge, Howard University, Brandeis, University of Wisconsin, University of Florida, Boston Conservatory at Berkley College of Music, Virginia Tech, and University of Southern Cal, just to name some of the colleges and universities you have chosen. Many of you are included in these numbers and schools just mentioned, but some of you are not. You may have struggled through high school with challenges not always known to others. Some of you, like myself many years ago, may not have grasped the importance of high school. But looking at the size of this crowd here tonight, you have people who believe in you. Throughout this commencement, I hope to leave you with one final lesson from Berkeley Schools. Recently, I reached out to some of the people who know you best. I asked some of your teachers, some staff members, some parents, and a few of your peers to help me with this final lesson. I asked each of them a question centered around the word hope. And what do they hope for you and your future? The hope I'm referring to tonight is sometimes used as a noun and sometimes as a verb. And don't worry, I'm not going to spend time teaching you a grammar lesson. You learned about nouns and verbs at your elementary school at either Angel or Burton, Norup or Pattengill or Rogers or maybe another school if you attended in a different district. The definition of the word hope I'm referring to, and according to the American Psychological Association, is that hope is a belief. It's not a wish. It's a belief that you can make things happen. It's about your mindset that you can overcome obstacles to accomplish your goals. Now, getting back to that question that I asked parents, some staff members, and students to help me prepare for this final lesson, I asked them, what is one of the most important lessons you hope the graduating class of 2022 learns from you or Berkeley Schools that they will take with them after they graduate? And I heard a range of thoughtful answers about their hopes or belief that you can make things happen. They said, I hope you meet new people. I hope you learn from your mistakes that you will make, and I hope you continue to show kindness and bring goodness into the world. Some of your loved ones also spoke to the notion that hope is a mindset, that you can overcome obstacles by remaining optimistic, being inclusive of others, having fun, and enjoying the ride. They shared many more valuable words of wisdom with me, but one theme seemed to emerge from all the answers to the question about what your peers, teachers, parents, and I hope for you. The answer is not about money. It's not about fame or a certain prestigious job. It isn't about obtaining a certain grade point in college or receiving a special award. The answer that emerged from what loved ones shared with me is they hope for you and your future that you discover what's important to you. They hope that no matter what is important to your friends or your future roommates or even loved ones, that you find what's important to you and you find your purpose and be curious about it. Be passionate about what matters to you, no matter how uncool or unpopular it may be. One parent said, I hope my child has the courage to be their own person and that they will allow their passion about what is important to them guide their decisions. Last month, I substitute taught for the orchestra teacher. Sorry, orchestra students. I substitute taught for Mr. Moy, and I asked some of them about what they hoped for you, the graduating class. One student in particular, her answer struck me. She said, I hope that they find what makes them happy in life. She didn't say, I hope that they are happy. And I'm guessing it's because she knows that happiness is really a state of mind. She said, I hope you find what makes you happy and that you pursue it. A similar message that came from some parents and staff. So my lesson for you tonight, and really the message of many loved ones, is about discovering what is important to you. It's my hope that you will find your passion, find your purpose, and let that empower you and others to make a difference in your future, your community, and the world around you. I look at the graduating class of 2022 in front of me tonight, and I am filled with hope because you are resilient and kind, and I believe you will overcome the twists and turns that will surely face you in life. But I believe you will overcome them because you have proven this again and again during your time at Berkley High School. Now up next, Jordan Wolf, the student body secretary, will help with this transition of us singing our alma mater, which was written by William D. Maria, who coincidentally was my mother's high school choir teacher. My mother graduated from Berkley High in 1965, and she is one of the most influential people in my life. She's influential because she believed in that growth mindset. She believes in giving and sharing kindness, and she believes in the hope that she has in others. My hope is not a wish, it's a belief in you, the graduating class of 2022. Thank you.
Please stand as the class of 2022 invites you to sing the Berkley High School alma mater. Seated.
Thank you. Before I begin, I just wanted to say that I was not expecting such a large turnout for my show. So, thanks guys. And yes, for those wondering, I do accept tips. One more thing. Hey Mom, hey Dad. I know you guys didn't know I was doing this until right now, but I just wanted to say that I love you guys so much, and I don't know where I'd be without you, and I'm so grateful for everything that you've done for me. So, thank you. All right, now that that's out of the way, let's get started. So, I've been in the Berkeley public school systems from the time that I was in kindergarten up until now. So for me and many of my friends who took the same path, I've had the privilege to watch them grow and become the amazing people they are today. From the very start, in Mrs. Finch's class, where we obsessed over the number scrolls that she had us write. Do you guys remember that? For those who aren't hip, your social status as a five-year-old was determined by the largest number that your scroll went up to. And I don't mean to brag, but mine went up to 10. Rivalries between classes were almost as big as the Wolverines and Spartans on game day. It got to the point where, unbeknownst to the teachers, we pretended to be like the Sharks and Jets from West Side Story, and fights would break out to decide who would reign supreme. They got pretty intense. Of course, this never happened, mainly because we didn't actually know what West Side Story was, but also because our teachers reminded us that even if we couldn't create a number scroll the size of War and Peace, we were small, intelligent, rowdy kindergartners with big possibilities for our future. That's the thing I've loved about Berkeley. Never in my 13 years of being a student have I met a teacher whom I didn't learn a valuable lesson from and who didn't push me to be the greatest version of myself. And look at me now. Although I didn't spend a lot of time in the office, thankfully, the faculty that I did get to know couldn't have been more supportive and readily available. Mr. Malosh, thank you so much for helping me out with my math homework back in sophomore year. I don't think I would have passed the class had you not slipped me the teacher's test answers. I owe you, buddy. That didn't happen either. He did actually help me out with my homework, though, which is really great. But mainly you and all the other teachers at Berkeley have always stayed positive no matter the circumstance. Whatever lies beyond in our journey is up to us now. But because of you guys, you've made it to where we can stand here today. I'm so honored to have met so many amazing people here. Let's give it up for the teachers. All right, now to talk to the seniors. It's kind of crazy, like, wow, we actually did it. I know this won't be our biggest accomplishment in our journey, but this is a huge milestone to be proud of. We haven't had a truly normal year of high school since freshman year. Yeah, sure, we didn't actually leave school until the second semester of sophomore year, but hey, that feels like forever ago. We missed so much, which sucks, but at least we had open note tests in online school. I understand that the entirety of COVID changed us rapidly and somewhat effectively. We were forced to spend 2 weeks with just our families. Whew, what a train wreck that could be at times. We really did go through a lot. That's why this graduation is so important to us. I've made so many friends here, it's unbelievable. If I could, I'd throw the biggest rager the world has ever seen, and you're all invited. But for those of you who I may never see again after graduation, I want to leave you with this. As some may know, I'm a huge Kendrick Lamar fan, so of course, I have to quote the master. Take advantage, do your best. Don't stress. You was granted everything inside this planet. Anything you imagine, you possess. Don't ever lose sight of your dream, because we've proven that we are smart and capable enough to overcome any challenge or obstacle that gets in our way. We are resilient and have stood strong against COVID and the impact that has had on our community. And sure, later on in life, we won't have to do things such as creating number scrolls or getting the test answers from the principal or writing a speech about graduating, but we will have to do what the world expects of us: live long and prosper. I hope that you have a life filled with happiness, laughter, and love. And since I have the microphone, I might as well do a little self-promotion. For those who don't know, I started a clothing brand about a year and a half ago called Society Disbanded. Yeah! Look at that. I know. I have a new drop on the way, but in the meantime, I got hoodies, shorts, and senior shirts for sale right now in the trunk of my car in the parking lot. So, if you want, after the ceremony is done, I'll be there hanging out with the trunk open, open for business. Thank you.
Testing 1, 2, testing. Oh, I always wanted to do that, so thank you. Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and the class of 2022. Wow. Who would have thought that the nervous group of freshmen who ran in hallways, waited until last minute to turn in assignments, because I know I did, and overused the word canceled would be sitting here today, getting ready to be sent off to the world. First of all, I would like to thank our teachers, school staff, Mr. Malosh, Ms. Krieger, Ms. Coleman, and our families. Can we give a round of applause for them, please? Thank you. I would also like to thank my mom and my family for always being a rock and being there for me. We really couldn't have done it without you. Now, to say that these past 4 years have been a ride would be an understatement. Throughout these years, we have laughed, cried, made mistakes, learned tough lessons, and built a community. And if you didn't know by now, we went through a pandemic. It not only taught everyone how to make TikToks and like 300 types of bread at home, like who needs to know how to make 300 types of bread? But it forced us to live and see the world in a much different way. During that time, we've had to miss so many of our normal high school experiences, like being kept apart from our loved ones, friends, and this Berkley community. Some of the experiences we have faced throughout have not only caused us to have to navigate the world in a much different way, but it prepared us for what is to come in this world, like learning to advocate for ourselves, others, and the injustices that we witness in the world. Whether it was through protests for the Black Lives Matter movement, or the rights of women and their bodies. And yeah, give it a round of applause. Yeah, go ahead. And even through computer screens, which I'm sure Zoom was thankful for, we learned to adapt and push through no matter how many curves life throws at us. And I am so proud of everyone for that. So as we leave today, some of us will have an entire roadmap of what our life will be, some will have an idea, and some are still in the unknown, and that's okay. Just remember that every one of us sitting here has something special, something that stands out, and it's up to you on what you will do with that. 9 years ago, I was diagnosed with an autoimmune illness that caused me to have to be in a wheelchair for 4 years. And during that time, I was bullied, people doubted me, and I felt invisible. But since starting high school, I dreamed that one day people will know my story and be inspired because of it. And because of perseverance, hard work, and ambition, I am now standing here giving a speech for the class of 2022, telling that story. So with my experience, I hope that you know as you go out into the world, there will be times when you want to stop and give up because you're scared of what could happen, or you feel as if you're not good enough, or someone tells you that you will never make it. But never forget the things that we accomplished and the lessons that we've learned in the past 4 years. Keep the thought that to accomplish great things, we must not only act, but also dream. Not only plan, but also believe. And that if you don't go after what you want, you'll never have it. If you don't ask, the answer will always be no. If you don't take a step forward, you will always be in the same place. So go out there and pursue your dreams and know that there will be losses, but there will also be wins. You will fail, but you will learn, and that every single chapter will eventually have an end. Thank you to everyone who has been part of this journey, and congratulations, class of 2022. We did it. Thank you.
Thank you. Now I just gotta outdo the squeegee guy over there. Superintendent Francis, President Blake, members of the Board of Education, faculty and staff, friends, relatives, and most importantly, members of the class of 2022, it is my privilege to address you for your commencement tonight. Before I begin, I think we would be remiss if we did not acknowledge the folks sitting behind you tonight. Your families, friends, teachers, counselors, and administrators have each helped to inspire and empower you to develop into the wonderful people you have become. These people have taught and motivated you to persevere through the tough times in order to accomplish great things. They have shaped and molded the person you are through their countless hours of love and care. Please stand up, turn around to face those folks, and give them a rousing applause. Now for the class of 2022. You and I have a lot in common. The most obvious correlation, and perhaps something you may not remember, is that your freshman year coincided with my first year as principal. Therefore, you are the first class that has had me as their principal for all 4 years of their high school experience. Essentially, we were freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and now seniors together. As I reflected back on my past 4 years, I can't help but feel like our experiences played out in a similar fashion to one another. To start this journey, let's go back to our freshman year. While there aren't many seniors that look back at their freshman year with longing, I think many of us feel differently. For starters, freshman year represented the one thing that has eluded us ever since, normalcy. Your ninth grade year and my first year as principal was the last full year of normal school that we had. Just saying it out loud astounds me. During our freshman year, we did what everyone does during their first year. We tried our best to figure things out. We met a lot of new people, tried to create as few waves as possible, and in a lot of ways, started to develop a vision for our future. When I think about my own first year as principal, I remember it being a whirlwind that flew by quicker than any other year of my career. Although there were ups and downs, I felt like in the end, there was a satisfaction in knowing that I made it through and that better things were ahead. I can imagine that feeling is not unlike what many of you felt after surviving your freshman year. As with most summer vacations, we got away, we recharged, and headed into our second year feeling a little more comfortable in our roles. If you were like me that year, you were mostly happy that you weren't the newbie. Although our experience was still minimal at this point, we took comfort in knowing our way around the block. We also became adept at handling various scenarios and obstacles that were presented to us. Yep, we were pretty much cruising along, feeling pretty good about ourselves in early 2020, weren't we? Now, as all of you unfortunately remember, March of 2020 threw us the biggest curveball that we had experienced to date. Our schools were shut down for the remainder of the year, and many of us finished that year with a somewhat incomplete feeling. To me, and I'm guessing to you as well, it was an unsatisfying way to end what had been a year of hard work, growth, and potential. Therefore, as we trudged our way through that summer and looked ahead to the school year, I could tell that many of us had a feeling of uncertainty in our stomachs. On top of that worry, you had the added burden of approaching what many consider to be a very important year of high school, your junior year. Now, full disclosure, I think that all years of high school are important in different ways. In all my years as an educator, I've routinely heard about the all-important and difficult junior year. To be quite honest, I've never really subscribed to that train of thought. Yes, students begin to challenge themselves by taking a more rigorous course load, and yes, they do have to take the SAT and start thinking about what comes next. However, I would also argue that juniors have grown in maturity, they are focused, and they have developed many important skills and tools that set the stage for them to achieve success. In that regard, I have always felt that juniors are much more prepared for their third year than they, or other people, often think they are. In the case of your class, however, I can unequivocally say that you had one of the most difficult junior years in the history of junior years. Looking back, it was also one of my most difficult years as a principal. Here's a quick list of some of the challenges we endured. An ever-changing calendar and schedule, quarantines, virtual learning, black Zoom screens, fanless sporting events, a virtual play, more quarantines, a virtual pep assembly, postponed and canceled concerts, COVID testing, an outdoor, then indoor, then outdoor again musical, hybrid learning, are you kidding me, more quarantines, and then finally, in-person learning. Each of these presented their own difficulties. In hindsight, however, I think we faced much bigger challenges than just those logistical ones. Essentially, we had to learn brand new skill sets and live in a constant state of adaptation. Somehow, we did this while living in an ever-changing and turbulent world. Thinking back to that third year, I can't believe how far we bent without ever breaking. All of us found ways to become incredibly efficient at balancing our schoolwork, our jobs, our sports and activities, and our families and friends. We continually adapted to the challenges that faced us and somehow still managed to have an incredibly successful school year. Even though it took a toll on us, I truly believe that in the end, we became stronger people, eventually developing the skills, voice, and vision that would propel us into this, our fourth year. Now, before I get into your senior year, I want to take a quick detour into Greek mythology. But no one saw that one coming. As I've thought about the journey of the class of 2022 and what they've gone through, I can't help but think about the phoenix. For those of you who may not know, a phoenix is a mythical bird believed to have special powers. When a phoenix reaches the end of a life cycle, which the Greeks believed to be around 500 years, it would build a nest, burst into flames, and be reborn from those ashes. When I reflect upon the last 26 months of your high school lives, I would classify it as nothing short of a symbolic burst of flames. However, when I look out here tonight and see the class of 2022, I can see that a beautiful phoenix has risen from the ashes of this global pandemic. The class of 2022 has survived one of the most chaotic, turbulent, and flame-filled 4 years of high school on record. Throughout those 4 years, and especially during your senior year, we've watched you step up to every challenge that was put in front of you. We've seen you routinely find innovative ways to solve the problems at hand. In the times you've gotten knocked down, we've witnessed you getting back up, dusting yourself off, and continuing to move forward. Most importantly, however, we've watched you stick together as a class and support one another through the journey that is Berkley High School. As a result of all this, you've built the trust and admiration of me, your teachers, your family, and your friends. Therefore, when I look out here tonight, I see a group that is beaming with confidence, certain of their own abilities, and more than ready to fly out of the ashes of this pandemic and into the future. I couldn't be prouder. Before I wrap up, I have one more quick story. As many of you know, it's no secret that I found a lot of joy, comfort, and inspiration in the Apple TV series Ted Lasso this year. For those of you who haven't watched, it's a comedy about the life of a professional soccer coach who knows nothing about the sport. Yes, I know it can be cheesy at times, and yes, I know that it can often portray an oversimplification of complicated matters. That being said, there is something about Coach Lasso that I find incredibly endearing. It seems like no matter what happens, Coach Lasso always believes in the good in others. Through that eternal optimism, he also has the foresight to see the potential in others that they sometimes fail to see in themselves. Although you have all experienced your share of ups and downs over the last 4 years, I hope you know that I, along with everyone sitting here tonight, believes in you the same way Coach Lasso believes in everyone around him. We believe in your intelligence to solve difficult problems. We believe in your perseverance to work through difficult barriers. We believe that although you'll make mistakes, you'll confidently fix them. Ultimately, we believe that you are ready for the next curveball the world throws at you. As a reminder of our belief in you, I designed a small flag for each graduate to take with them tonight. Better than squeegee guy? I'm hopeful that you will find a special place to hang it, and that it'll help you to keep three important things in mind. First, there is a Berkley bear head to remind you of your connection to everyone here tonight. You will always be a part of the Berkley family. Second, there is a phoenix to remind you of the turbulence of your 4 years of high school. Collectively, you've overcome what seem to be insurmountable obstacles. Lastly, and most importantly, there is the word belief. This is to remind you of this wonderful support system of people you have in your corner. Many are here tonight and will always be ready to help you attain that sky-high potential we see in you. All of us believe that you will do great things. I thank you all for being here tonight and wish all my Phoenixes in the class of 2022 the best of luck in what the future holds. Superintendent Francis, members of the Board of Education, tonight I can certify that all these students have met or exceeded the requirements set forth to graduate. Class of 2022. Class of 2022, you have made us proud and inspired us to become better at what we do. We hope that you all leave here tonight knowing two things. We will always care about you, and you will forever be special to us. Tonight, we are honored and privileged to call you graduates of Berkley High School.
Jack Evans Hubbard. Lindsay Brooke Wolf. Jordan Leah Wolf. Stella Reese Hurwitz. Evelyn Hope Alderman. George Anthony Alexander. Liza Kate Alexander. Evan Michael Allen. Dallas Atif Allison. Angeline Irene Amalut. Caitlin Elizabeth April. Madison Sophie April. Maxwell Daniel April. Colin Asher. Peyton Audrey Asher. Alvin Khalid Asmar. Angela Asmar. Victoria Dawn Auerbach. Cody Sebastian Avery. Benjamin Backow. Mason James Baker. Zedekus James Alexander Ball. Allie Marie Banks. Lillian May Barber. Meredith Helen Batchelor. Abigail Elizabeth Bayer. Caitlin Rose Bayless. Annabelle Sarah Bean. Eden Ryan Beckerman. Lola Kate Belshinsky. Luke Belkoff. Audrey Therese Bellock. Evan Carlo Bellamy. Eddie Maxwell Berlin. Rebecca Sheary Bernard. Zachary Thomas Balerian. Olivia Grace Bellowitz. Caleb Robert Biber Welser. Esther Ruth Benick. Zachary Bienenfeld. Thalia Victrice Bills. Evan James Blake. Noah Mayer Block. Coral Elizabeth Bogdan. Kalir Jutis Bomar. Brooke Elizabeth Bamarito. Ariane Marie Bonds. Ian Xavier Bonner. Tori Marie Willow Boykins. Brianna Raylan Bradley. Micah Maureen Bradley. Benjamin Michael Bugby. Will Quinn Burns. Russell Thomas Calhoun. Christopher James Campbell. Stefano Xavier Carlesso. Ian Patrick Carpenter. Mia Hannah Caesar. Brianna Lily Sharon. Fanta Cece. Christopher Mark Clark. Yeah. Joshua Michael Clements. Matthew Lorenzo Coletta. Morgan Isabel Collins. Parker Elaine Collins. Gabrielle Marie Connors. Emily Victoria Cook. Noah Chase Cooper. Jason Richard Cox II. Layla Winifred Daigle. Brigeanette Renee Darling. Dennis Davidov. Sophia Rose Day. Mark Isaac Rayner DeFore Graves. Benjamin Philip DeRozier. Milani Joy Ray DeVerger. Jacob Alexander Dines. Jada Lynn Doman Zurich. Jake Thomas Domzalski. Jackson David Dowhan. Julia Marie Drew. Lindsay Jordan Dudovitz. Sam James DuLong.
I've been told to pause for a moment. Are you ready? Grace Elizabeth Elliott. Amelia Grace Fedor. Maxwell Keith Fagenson. Alexander Cole Fassbender. Hannah Willow Findling. James Flanders IV. Emily Nicole Flood. Jack Alexander Flood. LaShayla Monier Franklin. Maxwell Michael Frazier. Joseph George Friedel III. Max Elizabeth Freeman. Max Theo Friedman. Joseph Michael Frontera. Alexander Lewis Gadd. Rachel Hava Gaft. Nina Patrice Georgeff. Ariel Joan Gibson. Santino Luigi Giglio. Yeah. Lauren Elizabeth Gedke. Nicholas John Goldsmith. Abigail August Golombuski. Alicia Pumpkin Ariella Grand. Nathan Alexander Green. Ava Francesca Griffin. Abigail Brooke Gervitz. Skylar Elise Hale. Tamia Monet Hall. Sovereign Shamul Halleck. Audrey Caroline Hambrick. Maxwell Pierce Hammond. Jake Dylan Handorf. Jasmine Rose Harrington. Destiny LaShawn Elise Harris. Isabel Grace Hay. Iris Serafina Hayes. Ava Christine Heiler. Kavanaugh Hellenberger. Mark Frederick Heron Jr. Ari Hirsch. Sydney Elise Height. Reginald Holmes Jr. Peyton Thomas Horvath. Kamora Iwana Howard. Ayana Howard. My apologies. Ryan Carlton Hughes. Raina Jane Jacobs. Trevor Inman Jackson. Jade Jordan Jackson. Isabel Hannah Jansen. Sophia Carly Jansen. Amir Julianne Johnson. Spencer Stevie Josephowicz. Aurora Rose Cadlitz. Katrina Chris Kajal. Christian John Capitan. Olivia Grace Haru. Amelia Jane Karp. Lindsay Brooke Katz. Lily Rachel Keefe. Robert Abraham Keller. Jenna Ellen Kern. Joshua Wesley Kiesling. Caitlin Ashley Kizzy. Ruth Mary Klein. Mark Zachary Cotilla. Benjamin Michael Kramer.
Nice job, Ryan.
Ryan Jacob Kraus. Frederick Fritz Michael Krieger. Orly Blake Krugel.
I'm proud of you.
Vladislav Krasinski. Ellie Elizabeth Kubicki.
Rihanna Catrice Langley. Charles Patrick Larabelle. Emily Ruth Lely. Claire Francis Leonard. Benjamin Mayer Lerner. Isabella Mary Ligi. Caitlin Rose Linehan. Colin Daniel Linehan. Leanne Ashley Loon. Gabriella Maria Luna Jen. Sarah Rose McGuire. Annabella Rose Maniscalco. Nolan Blake Manista. Allison Marie Mann. Jayshawn Armaya Mann. Anthony Allen Marcos. Logan Jean-Maurice Martin. Lucas Xavier Matthews. Benjamin Gentry Maurice. Maya Elizabeth Maurice. Zachary James Maurice. Jack Lawrence McClure. Kelsey Allison McDonald. Finnegan Gregory Mallerman. Connor Douglas Dennis McGlone. Richard Austin McGrath V. Donovan James McKeague. Sean Matthew McKenzie. Tiana Dolores Meadows. Lev Gershon Mechnikov. Maya Priya Meltzer. Noah Jared Michelson. Eva Catherine Suzanne Mitchell. Mary Frances Mixon. Andrew Michael Momper. Quinn Javier Morrow. Ian Cooper Morton. Najee Yasmeen Mosley. Samantha Jane Moutsatsos. Griffin Austin Murray. Ryan Luke Nakasher. Jaden Lewis Nelson. Macy Lynn Nowak. Drake Azurite Odoms. Irie Rose Otley. Theodore Ross Otto. Caitlin Rose Otwell. Jacqueline Renee Parent. Jason Edward Parks. Brandon Christopher Peacher. Jillian Surrey Peak. Benjamin Michael Pierce. Henry Lewis Pennington. Elliot Abraham Perkins. Alexa Reese Filko. Seth Aiden Pollard. Anthony Deshaun Pope Jr. Alexa Michelle Pop. Deja Dominique Powell. Devin Clay Price. Timothy Lawrence Prier. Ava Faye Quayle. Jack Andrew Qualman. Laurel Elizabeth Queen. Jack Patrick Quinn. Jeffrey Michael Rammel. Mark Hollinger Redman. Keisha Rose Ray Downs. Lacey Nicole Reichling. Clayton Thomas Reed. Isabella Sean Rendelman. Ariana Ann Rhodes. Annalise Elizabeth Ringe. Reagan Grace Robert. Tegan Padilla Roberts. Delaney Lamar Robinson. Raquel Rose Roper Payne. Adam Edward Rosenthal. Anna Ryan Roth. Elon Michael Runenkevich.
Jonath Sajan. Andrew Ahmed Salan. Natalia Salmon. Ethan Jacob Sanders. Haley Ann Shaw. Colin Michael Schmidt. Asa Charles Schnackel. Ella Marie Schneider. Madison Alyssa Cecilia Schoenfeld. Mira Hope Schuf. Isaac Christopher Schultz. Sophia Lily Schultz. Bryn Morgan Scully. Ryan Harrington Sirwa. Riley Grace Sewell. Meng Tong Shi. Andrew Nathan Sievertson. Dylan Hunter Selecki. Zachary Robert Simmons. Mary Margaret Yubao Sipes. Annabelle Quinn Sidorek. Caroline Rachel Slutsky. Alicia Marie Smith. Leah Renee Smith. Natalie Jean Smith. Riel Ariane Smith. Zaria Renee Smith. Emily Kathleen Snyder. Symphony Jaslyn Sokolowski. Aaron David Lee Spradley. Aurora Jane Bailiff Susannis. Nicole Elizabeth Ann Sawinski. Nicholas Ryan Spada. Max Spielman. Mary Lawson Spurgeon. Gabriel Carlin Stacy. Emily Nicole Stevenson. Lena Kathleen Stevens. Alexander Anthony Steef. Jonathan Daniel Stowinski. Megan Rose Streetman. Ella Grace Sturts. Taryn Renee Sudbury. Jackson James Swaninger. Olivia Catherine Swike. Aaron James Swords. Stephanie Tavares Garcia. Caden Elvis Teicher. William Michael Tillotson. Sabrina Melissa Tomlinson. Courtney Janelle Tracy. Andrew Robert Trepik. James Charles Troop. Kennedy Lorraine Tunnicliffe. Eliana Valerie Turner. Grace Lillian Turner. Lily Irene Turner. Ella Ray Turpin. Brandon Kyle Urich. Emily Mallory Vanderwall. Jake Michael Van Overbeck. Levon Robert Vesey. Samuel Ryan Veder. Zachary Charles Vigliotti. Annabelle Elizabeth Vollmar. Briar Bowles. Corey Elijah Walker. Arshad Fidel Wallace. Skylar May Walter. Taylor Marie Walton. Clifford Ray Ward Taylor Jr. Dominique Toussaint Ware. Amaya Nicole Watkins. Grace Catherine Watson. Yoan Pierce Watson. Madeline Kate Watts. Noah Wee Reese Webster. Brooklyn Anaya Weems. Jonah Riley Weinbaum. Brandon Ashton Weingarten. Kayla Elizabeth Welsher. Ella Grace Workmeister. Ava Marie White. Ashlyn Olivia Whitehead. Myla Sadie Whiteman. Paige Brianna Wilkes Spencer. Bryson Willoughby. Patrick Wilson. Luke Robert Wismer. Matilda Ellie Wittig. Hannah Noelle Wood. Rianica Ann Wrench. Jackson Barry Wright. Camden Graham Youngquist. Robert James Yowell.
Thank you. Congratulations, everybody. Parents and guests, please remain seated until the graduates have exited the pavilion and you have been dismissed. Class of 2022, please stand. It has been my honor to serve as your president this past year. As a final goodbye, always remember to be kind and to spread love. Although these are our last moments spent together, the memories we made along the way are unforgettable. Now, please reach up to your cap and join me in switching your tassel from the left to the right side. Congratulations, fellow alumni of Berkley High School.
Thank you. Please do it in this order if you can. Get your instruments put away, taken care of, nice, and then let's start putting stands on racks, percussion. We need to break down the stands and put cymbals in bags.